assets could include village shop, pub, community centre, children's centre, allotment, library, cinema, recreation ground. In order to qualify as a community asset, the current main use of the asset should further the social well-being or cultural, recreational or sporting interests of the local community or has done within the last 12 months. The asset should continue to be used for the further social well-being or interests of the local community or will do so again within the next 5 years. So my view is it qualifies on that basis. If it's a list, owners of a listed asset cannot dispose of them without letting the council they know that they intend to sell the asset or grant a lease for more than 25 years, waiting until the end of the 6-week interim moratorium period. There's a lot of detail here, I'm just giving you the bare bones. Waiting until the end of a 6-month full moratorium period if the local authority receives a request from a community group to be treated as a potential bidder. Those are after managed to list it as an asset of community value. So the criteria, as far as I can judge, seems to be with us. Nominations to list an asset of community value can be made by town and parish councils, or town council. Listing an asset allows time for the community or groups to prepare a bid if the asset is offered for sale or long lease within 5 years of that listing. So taking on board what Mr. Gardner and others have said, that should this be, how can I phrase it? Should this become part of a neighbourhood plan, the fact that we have listed it does protect it to a certain extent and gives us the time that would be necessary to do all the things that would need to be done before we could even look at acquiring such a building for community use, because as has been said, for example, it has a rateable value of £80,000 a year. It's one example. We know it was renovated according to grade listed requirements only about 4 years ago now, maybe 5 years ago. So we know that it's in good order currently, but you have to look to the future if you're going to take on board anything like this. So that is the basic, very basic information. I hope that answers your question, Councillor Burden.
Yeah. So basically, Chairman, what we would do if we asked for it to be listed is put a block on it.
Yes.
So that we have time to think.
We have, well, not necessarily that much time to think, but it does give us more time than currently at the moment. Right now, for all I know, somebody could have walked into Enterprise Inns and says, I want to buy it and I'm going to pay you X million pounds. We don't have X million pounds, but if we create it, list it, ask to be listed as an asset of community value, it does give us breathing space to formulate ideas, views or whatever. So that was the first proposal and it is listed, Portishead, I just say, I'm not proposing it at the moment, just repeating it. Portishead Town Council to agree to make an application for the Old Mill Public House to be listed as an asset of community value. That was the first half of what I wanted to do, because when it was up for lease last time, 18 months or so ago, I did inquire about how it was being leased, etc. And at that time I was told there were two people or two businesses interested in leasing it, and therefore Enterprise weren't willing to talk to me at all. And that was entirely me, that was my personal thought. It's a flagship building, it's really important, it has status on the high street, and to my way of thinking, it does deserve better than it's had in the time I've known it, which I know is a very short time, but in the time I've known it, it does seem very sad that it's now empty again and boarded up. So that's where
just very quickly, I've spoken to the South West Regional Director in Enterprise Inns, and he is very keen on doing something with the Town Council. He really appreciates all these sort of ideas. We'll see where we go. Councillor Cameron.
Yes, I think that we're very far away from a proposal on this. There clearly would be considerable expense involved, and the idea that it should be self-financing, it would require quite an income stream to come from it to do that. And the one thing we should remember is that the lesson has been learned so many times that councils are not good at running businesses. I think I'm in the astonishing position of finding myself in agreement with Mrs. Hennessy.
All right.
Don't two, send me a letter, will
two
you?
Two tonight, fantastic.
We usually find ourselves with a big loss maker. I think the white line is, in many ways, David Arndt's phrase, the white elephant, and it could turn into a black hole.
I find that I'm in a position where I could not, and I repeat, could not vote for this to become listed as an asset of community value at the moment. And the reason for that is that if we went down that route, we would stymie the opportunity of Enterprise Inn to get another publican in and to get another viable business in Austria. And I don't want to see that happen. We had success over the precinct because we went to the landlord and we had conversations with the landlord. That's why the precinct is going to be repaved and redone, because North Somerset were put in an awkward position, and I'm sorry David, that's the case that happened. We need to go and be in a position where we go and talk to Enterprise, not just one person, but two or three councillors who understand how business works. It's all very well thinking pie in the sky. My husband and I own two properties in the high street. They're 19th century. They are expensive to run. You want something done to it, you have to find a lot of money to get it done. Repointing. You look at that building, it is white all over. How often is it going to have to be repainted and decorated? This motion is too early, and I'm sorry, I can't vote for it. What I can vote for is that we look into the matter as to what the situation is, have meetings, and bring it back to the council when we have some solid facts about what they want, what we can afford, and whether we can get grants. Now, grants are funny things. I've got quite a lot of experience of obtaining grants through the Youth Centre. They are difficult to come by. North Somerset is considered to be a wealthy area and it is very difficult to pick up grants. Very difficult indeed. Yes, we have managed to get grants. We have been very successful. But we've been doing it for a long time. And we've been in a position where we know where to pick them up when we can. This is going to be a huge, huge amount of money that we're going to need for this. It's not going to fall out of the sky. We also, as well as meeting Enterprises, need to go and look at the inside of this building. I understand from somebody I was speaking to yesterday that you can't see the mill inside anymore because it's been all concreted over, and the flat that is upstairs has to be accessed through the kitchens. So, you know, these are things that we need to look at. We need to find out more, and we need to do it as a group and find out what the ramifications really are. This motion is too early.
Well, we're certainly going to get a balanced view when we get into this. No doubt about it. Anybody else want to make a comment on that? Could we press on? Councillor Mason.
Thank you. Before Councillor Cruz spoke, I thought that yes, to ask for it to be a community asset, I thought was a very good idea. Listening to Councillor Cruz, I can see exactly where she's coming from. And yes, I can see very clearly her concern that if we did apply and get this asset of community value, we could stop somebody else turning it back into a pub. I don't know how well all the pubs are doing along the high street. They may be all doing well, I don't know. We have a lot of other facilities where people can go in the evenings now, during the day as well. I think it would, personally, I think it would be useful to have a meeting at the pub with as many councillors as possible, and also representatives from Enterprise Inns. That way we are fully informed of what's happening. He could then, or that he or she could then tell us more about being a community asset, and whether that would stop anybody who did want to run it as a pub, or whether it would perhaps just delay, perhaps for a few months, 6 months or whatever. Now, whether somebody who wanted to run it as a pub would accept that delay. Well, during which time we could then make up our mind what exactly we wanted to do, or where we wanted to pull out. So I think the first thing, as far as I'm concerned, is that it would be useful to have a meeting with Enterprise Inns. Thank you.
And finally, Councillor Cottrell.
I think points from Councillors Cruise and Mason have been very well made. As far as Councillor Mason's comment about how a pub's doing on the high street, I understand that the poacher is again seeking a new tenant. It's still being run, but again, to my knowledge, that is the third one in the past 5 years. So I don't know if that is...
Excuse me, can I interject? I don't think we should be speaking about other people's financial matters in a council meeting.
Okay. In fact, let's leave that there. Finally, anybody from the general public, any more on that?
Very quickly. Just going on quickly from what I suggested about dual use from the community and from a public house point of view, it occurred to me that there is nowhere in Porter's Head that holds the marriage licence for civil marriages. If you wish to contract that kind of marriage outside of Porter's Head, you have to spend your money elsewhere, nearest being at Lee Court or somewhere in Clevedon or in Weston-super-Mare, or even have to go to Bristol. In Porter's Head, there are a lot of people who may have the means to want to stay in their own hometown and have the large amounts of money which people spend on weddings nowadays of all kinds. Why not make it a venue for all sorts of things, not necessarily just making it a civic building, but have it as a dual use, somewhere that is a focal point.
Thank you very much. Personal airing on that one. Lots of views, good and bad. I'm sure we'll make some progress on it or not. We have to reinstate standing orders now and get back to the agenda.